So let's start with the equilibrium in chemical process. Equilibrium in chemical processes. In chemical process, you know, the chemical reaction take place, new substance are formed, chemical change take place. In physical process, just only physical state of the substance change. So first of all, we need to know what is the characteristics of chemical equilibrium. As we discussed earlier, equilibrium is always in dynamic nature. What is dynamic nature? That means it is not stationary. It keeps on moving on both the direction, but at the same rate, right? So if I say that equilibrium, so here at equilibrium, rate of forward reaction equals the rate of backward reaction. Both the reactions at the same rate. Suppose you take A plus B, they react to form C plus D. But when it reaches to the equilibrium, C and D again combine to form A plus B. So both the rates become equal. So if I, this is called forward reaction. From conversion A to B is called rate of forward reaction. And conversion of, we can say, C to AB back is called rate of backward reaction. This is forward and this is backward. So at equilibrium, what happens? Rate of forward equals to the rate of backward. How we can show this with the help of a graph? Suppose you have here a rate and here you have time. With respect to time, with respect to time, initially, you know, reactants are more. So initially product are zero. So what will happen? The forward reaction, you can show like this, and backward reaction when equilibrium is read like this. And here we can say this is the equilibrium point. This is for forward reaction and this is for reverse or backward reaction. Now question comes, why we take forward on this side and backward here? Because initially reactant are more. Product is zero, so we started backward from zero. And we started forward reaction from high concentration, right? So when the equilibrium is reached, both the rate become equals. So we call it equilibrium point. So for any equilibrium, whether it is physical and chemical, both the rates are equal. That is rate of forward equals to rate of backward. And secondly, equilibrium is dynamic in nature that we have discussed. You got the meaning of dynamic nature of equilibrium. Dynamic nature means it is not stationary. The rate of forward equals to rate of backward. Now, we can make some important conclusions from these discussions that what is the characteristics of a chemical equilibrium? What are the characteristics of chemical इक्विलिब्रियम। फर्स्ट वी कैन राइट एट इक्विलिब्रियम एट इक्विलिब्रियम द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट एंड प्रोडक्ट बिकम कॉन्स्टेंट। कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट एंड प्रोडक्ट नॉट इक्वल, रिमेंबर इट्स नॉट इक्वल, दे बिकम कॉन्स्टेंट। सेकेंड थिंग यू कैन राइट दैट द इक्विलिब्रियम इज डायनामिक, इट्स डायनामिक, that is at equilibrium the rate of forward equal to rate of backward, rate of forward equals to the rate of backward. Third point you can write, equilibrium is established only when no product is allowed to escape, that is closed container. So that is the must condition, closed container is needed. And fourth thing you can write, equilibrium can be attained from either side, it can be attained from either side, either from forward or from backward, and there is a no effect of catalyst. You say why? Because catalysts help to achieve the equilibrium, it doesn't affect or disturb the equilibrium, it helps into formation of the product. So once the product is formed, that means again set up into the equilibrium process. So these are the few points which we need to remember, the characteristics of chemical equilibrium. Then we need to know what is laws of chemical equilibrium and what is equilibrium constant. Laws of chemical equilibrium and equilibrium constant. See, there is a law called law of mass action. What is law of mass action? Law of mass action says that ki koi bhi reactions hai, any reactions, the rate of reaction is proportional to product of the active masses of the reactant, each raised to power their stoichiometric coefficient in a balance equation. How? Suppose if I take the reaction A plus B gives C plus D. Suppose their coefficient are small a, small b, small c and small d. So here rate of this reaction, suppose forward, rate of forward reaction is directly proportional to what? Concentration of what? A and B. Because yahan pe reactant kaun hai? A aur B hai forward ke liye. Aur agar ye backward hoga, to reactant kaun ho jayenge? C and D. To forward reaction kiske directly proportional hai? Concentration of product of A and B. Reactant ke directly proportional hai, not the product. Each raised to power their stoichiometric coefficient. क्या है यहाँ पे A और यहाँ पे क्या है B. Same अगर आप लिखेंगे rate of backward reaction. So backward के लिए reactant कौन है? C and D. So that is concentration of C, concentration of D, each raised to power their C and D. So here ये जो है उसको बोलते हैं law of mass action, right? So if we apply the law of mass action, the rate of forward and rate of backward equals to this. For this type of reaction, at equilibrium, we know that at equilibrium, rate of forward equals to the rate of backward that we have studied. Now, if we apply, what is rate of forward? You will say rate of forward for this reaction equals to what you can write. You need to take a constant, equal sign le rahe. So we'll take K, forward F, A, B, power A and B. Same, what is rate of forward, backward? You will say KB, constant, C and D, each raised to power C and D. Now, dono ko equal kar diya. So right here, forward or backward ki values yahan rakh do. You will write KF, A and B, each raised to power A and B, equal to KB, C and D, power C and D. Now, if I divide KF upon KB, isko shifting of terms kiya, then it becomes C power C D A and B. Power coefficient A, B, C, and D. Right? That equals to the a new constant called KC. The ratio of KF, KF upon KB is the KC. So here KC is called what? It is equilibrium constant. It is called equilibrium constant. And KB or KF, they are the constant for forward and backward reaction. So here we can say this is called the law of equilibrium, chemical equilibrium. This is called law of chemical equilibrium. So what this law says, how we can define this? We can define that at a given temperature, the product of the reaction product, these are the C and D are the reaction product, raised to their respective stoichiometric coefficient in the balance equation, divided by product of the concentration of the reactant raised to their individual stoichiometric coefficient, has a constant value. Means here, the concentration of product upon concentration of reactant, each raised to power their stoichiometric coefficient always has a fixed value, constant value, and that is called equilibrium constant, KC. C stands for concentration, right? So for that, here we have taken KF and KB, forward and backward, and the ratio of KF and KB is called KC, and KC is called equilibrium constant. Suppose its value is 1. What it says, that means both the concentration of reactant and product are 1. Because 1 are, that means product or reactant ka jo concentration hai wo same hai, right? So apan ko ye mathematical expression jo hai wo derive bhi karna aur sab reactions ke liye likhna bhi hai. Suppose mere paas ek equation hai, H2 plus I2 gives HI, right? 2HI. To uska KC kaise likhunga? What is the product? You will say HI. So HI likhenge. Ab uska stoichiometric coefficient kya hai? 2, power 2 likhenge. Upon reactant kya hai? H2. Coefficient kya hai? 1. Kuch nahi likhenge. I2. That is KC. Agar inki value diya to value dal denge. In this way, you have to write the value of KC for various reactions. Clear? So,
yes, sir.
Suppose if you take NH3, two NH3 are formed from N2 and H2. N2 plus H2 gives two NH3. Or here I'll write 3. So, what is the value of KC for this reaction? How you will write? You will write KC equals to N2. Reactant is what, N2? Oh, sorry, product is NH3. We have less than 1 minute, so we'll do in the next class.